And look, FIRCO has learnt the Commerce Commission's investigating a case of misleading pricing.
It won't reveal details while its investigation is still active, but it came up as we were asking them about supermarket pricing.
Or more specifically, those supermarket bargains. Because we want to know, how special is that special really? Garth hit the aisles to find out.
Supermarkets are always telling us, if we shop with them, we'll save.
Chicken Week.
Find great ways to save. Specials that help you save every week.
And for good reason, it seems.
The words like special, deal, promotion actually trigger reward center in our brains. It actually releases chemicals like dopamine and oxytocin when you feel like you've won something or you got a deal.
Right, so it's like the same chemical thrill you get from eating the chocolate.
Almost a double hit when you eat the chocolate that you got on sale.
Our brains love a bargain. But how do we actually know if we're getting one unless we check?
For 10 weeks now, I've been doing a weekly shop of a different kind, looking at the same items, but photoshopping, filling up the phone rather than the baskets, tracking the prices to see if those specials really are that special.
We've been shopping around, making sure we visited each of the big three supermarket chains all close by and competing with each other in Auckland. Countdown, New World and Pack and Save. Plus three of them in Christchurch for good measure, with an eye on those specials, keeping in mind, special to you might not be special to me.
A special is something that's less than what you would normally pay for.
I think I've probably got a bargain.
What about like extra low? What does that mean?
That it's really cheap. Like, heaps cheaper than normal.
It's all over the show really, isn't it?
And it probably doesn't help that there is no legal definition of the usual selling price. The Commerce Commission says
retailers may mislead consumers if they refer to a claimed usual price, which is out of date because it is no longer the price the goods or services are commonly charged at.
It's investigating a misleading price case now.
As this is an active investigation, we have no further comment at this time.
But shoppers have plenty to say.
Some companies actually seem to be always on special, so what's the true price?
You've actually made me think, because now I'm thinking, how do we know?
We can't remember what they put what it was last week.
Even so, turns out we have a feeling that we know what we should be paying.
That might be sort of the usual sale price, that might be the last price that they paid, or it could be a price that is kind of set for them as a bit of an anchor, which is also sometimes called psychological pricing.
So let's have a look and see if the anchor is standing firm or drifting a little. Back to Howick Historical Village. You wouldn't have found most of these on the shelves in 1848, but if the modern supermarket's got a deal for you.
Like Pepsi on special at New World, 10 weeks out of 10. We never saw it at the anchor price once. At Countdown, it was on special 6 weeks out of 10, and at Pack and Save, the price fluctuated, though they marked that as an extra low, even in the weeks when it was the same price at Countdown just up the road. Yogurt in a pot that had flipped their Victorian lids, and perhaps being just as baffled as we are to find these 12 packs on special 8 weeks out of 10 at Countdown, 4 weeks out of 10 at New World, but always just a bit cheaper at Pack and Save. Now, fresh, whole chicken. I'm thinking here that they might have supplied that with the feathers still on. But at New World, they had this product on special every time we visited. And Pack and Save had it at a higher price, an everyday low price, which in this case is maybe code for not so low. And of course, you can't have a chicken without eggs. New World had this brand on special for 7 weeks out of the 10 that we visited. And at Countdown, a competing brand, it was 6 weeks out of 10 on special. We could go on, but the big picture must be getting clear by now. Half the time, about 2/3 of the products we tracked at New World and Countdown were not at their advertised usual price. And at Pack and Save, prices fluctuated. So, is that special starting to seem like maybe it ought to just be called the price?
And if not, just how are they setting those anchor prices?
We asked the supermarkets if they'd be prepared to show us, but they prefer to tell us.
We take our obligations under the Fair Trading Act very seriously, and we understand that any discount must be off genuinely used prices.
Because Pack and Save and New World stores are individually owned and operated,
although some prices/promotions are rolled out regionally or nationally, the majority are determined at the store level.
Countdown owns and runs all of its stores.
We are very conscious that if a product is discounted for too long, there is a risk that the discounted price can become the usual price. Each of our supermarkets has around 20 to 30,000 products, depending on the size, but we have systems in place to ensure that we manage this.
But no detail from either company on how they anchor these deals. Hopefully they've been more forthcoming with the Commerce Commission, which is currently investigating supermarket pricing. Its findings are due in November. Until then, don't forget...
The word special still just like... it still has that psychological effect.
Consider yourselves warned.
Oh, it's interesting, isn't it? Yeah. I think one takeaway is if you're buying some of those standard products, basically don't pay full price, wait, because it will surely come on special sometime soon. Also, just so you know, we've taken Garth aside and we've explained to him that the creature he was looking at was a duck and not a chicken.
Could foul up anyway. Oh, dear joke. Sorry about that. All right, now, about the Commerce Commission. That was terrible. The Commerce Commission's investigation into misleading pricing, we'll let you know as soon as we got some details on that.